Hello friends, welcome back to Best Way to Study. In this video we are going to discuss about Infosys model paper. Okay, so in this model paper we are going to discuss few questions which will be regularly repeating in Infosys paper, okay, in basically the written test. Okay, let's start our video. First question is, father's age is 3 times the son's age. After 3 years, father's age is 10 years more than twice the son's age. What is the father's present age? Okay, I'm repeating the question. Father's age is 3 times the son's age. After 3 years, father's age is 10 years more than twice the son's age. What is the father's present age? Okay, so this is age problems. In age problems, for quantitative aptitude, you'll be finding the similar problem. Okay, next question is, 3 friends divided chocolates equally. All of them ate 4 chocolates. The total number divided are equal, but the total number of remaining chocolates is equal to that of 1 has after division. Find the original number divided. Okay, you'll find in ratio and proportion. Okay, I'm repeating the question. 3 friends divided the chocolates equally. All of them ate 4 chocolates. The total number divided are equal, but the total number of remaining chocolates is equal to that of 1 has after division. Find the original number divided. I'll explain you the question. There are 3 friends and they divided the chocolates equally. All of them ate the 4 chocolates and the total number divided are equal. Okay, they divided the chocolates equally, but after dividing, the remaining chocolates are equal to the number of 1 has after division. Okay, if the remaining chocolates, let it be x. Okay, let the remaining chocolates be x is equal to one person who has the same ratio of chocolates. Okay, means out of 4, like out of the friends, like the, let there be 3 friends. Okay, out of 3 friends, one of the friend has x chocolates remaining with him. Okay, means the remaining chocolates are x, which is equal to the ratio of chocolates which one of the friend has after division. Okay, that is the question. Now they are asking you to find what is the number of original chocolates divided. Okay, next question is, there are 20 poles with constant distance between each pole. A car takes 30 seconds to reach 18th pole. Then how much will it take to reach the last pole? I am repeating the question. There are 20 poles with constant distance between each pole. Okay, a car takes 30 seconds to reach the 18th pole. How much distance will it take to reach the last pole? This question, this similar kind of questions in quantitative aptitude, you can find in time, speed and distance problems. Okay, now let's go with next question. At 6 o'clock, the clock ticks 6 times. The time between the first and the last tick is 30 seconds. How much time does it take at 12 o'clock? Okay, this is time problem. I'm repeating the question. At 6 o'clock, the clock ticks 6 times. The time between the first tick and the last tick is 30 seconds. How much time does it take at 12 o'clock? Okay, now moving to next question. Light glows for every 13 seconds. How many times did the light glow between 1 hour, 1:57:58 AM and 3 hours, 20:47 AM. Okay, I'm repeating the question. Light glows for every 13 seconds. How many times did it glow between 1 hour, 57:58 AM and 3 hour, 20:47 AM? Okay, now let's move to the next question. 5 people A, B, C, D, E are related to each other. 4 of them make one true statement each as follows. Okay, the first statement is D is saying B is my father's brother. Okay, D, what did D say? He said B is my father's brother. Okay, next statement, B is saying, okay, what B said? E is my mother-in-law. Okay, next, third statement, E is saying, what E said? C is my son-in-law's brother. Okay, next statement is C is saying, E is my brother's wife. Okay, which of the following statement is the correct statement? Okay, so this is the question. There are five people, they are making different statements. Out of these four statements, which statement is correct, we need to say. Okay, that is the question. Okay, let's pass to next question. An investor purchased, this is shares, stocks and shares question. Okay, next, an investor purchased shares of stock at certain price. Okay, let the price be X. If the stock increased in price is rupees 0.25 per share and the total increased for X shares was rupees 12.50, how many shares of stock has been purchased? Okay, I'm repeating the question. Listen carefully. An investor purchased shares of stock at certain price. If the stock increased, the price is rupees 0.25 per share and the total increased for X shares was 12.50 rupees, how many shares of the stock has been purchased? Okay, this is the question and these are the options which are given. Okay, option A is 25, option B is 50, option C is 75, option D is 100 and option E is 125. Okay, this is stocks and shares problem. Okay, related to investment. Next, last but one question. Let's see. This is discount profit and loss problem. Okay, a merchant sells an item at 20% discount, but he still makes gross profit of 20% of the cost. What percent of cost would be gross profit on the item have been if it has sold without discount? I'm repeating the question. I'll explain you the question. A merchant is giving 20% discount on an item, but still he is gaining the profit of 20% of the cost. Okay, next, what percent of the cost would be the gross profit on the item if it been sold without discount? Okay, see, I'm explaining the question. For example, let the merchant be me. Okay, if I'm giving 20% discount also, still I'm getting 20% profit on cost. Okay, then if I don't give discount of 20%, what profit will I get? Okay, if I sell the same product without discount, what gross profit will I get is the question. Okay, let's see the options. Option A is 20%, option B is 40%, option C is 50%, option D is 60%, and option E is 66.6%. Okay, now let's see the most important crypt arithmetic problem. Okay, you can expect minimum one crypt arithmetic problem in every written test of Infosys. This is for sure. Sometimes it will come like two questions will be asked, sometimes even three questions will be asked, but at least one question of crypt arithmetic is must in the is really must in the written test of Infosys. Now let's see the question. This the crypt arithmetic question will be in this format. Example: go plus 2 is equal to out, o plus u plus t is equal to question mark. Okay, go plus 2 is equal to out, o plus u plus t is equal to how much? Options are A 10, B 8, C is 3, and D is 9.